Reconciliation is Monday, April 11th at 7 p.m. The Lord's Supper will be celebrated on Holy Thursday, April 14th at 7 p.m. The Living Stations will be at 2:30 on Good Friday, and the Good Friday service will be in the evening at 7 p.m. If you are a greeter, Eucharistic minister, or server and are available for the Easter Masses, please sign up in the vestibule. Please note, there will be no 5:30 Mass next Saturday. The Easter Vigil will begin at 7 p.m. An Easter Sunrise service will be held at Mosquito Lake at 6:30 a.m. on April 17th. This service is sponsored by Loaf. Everyone is welcome. Please stand for a silent procession for Palm Sunday.
Good morning, everyone. I'd like to welcome all of you to Holy Week, Palm Sunday. And we're in for, the Mass is going to be a little bit different. I'm going to have a prayer, a blessing of the palms. There'll be a gospel. And then the Mass will be the same. And we're in for a real treat because our 8th graders and a few 7th graders are going to do the mime. In the name of the Father and of the Son, of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. My friends, since the beginning of Lent until now, we have prepared our hearts by penance and charitable works. Today we gather together to herald with the whole church the beginning of a celebration of our Lord's Paschal mystery. That is to say, of his passion and resurrection. For it was so to accomplish this mystery that he entered his own city of Jerusalem. Therefore, with all faith and devotion, let us commemorate the Lord's entry into the city of our salvation, following his footsteps, so that being made by his grace partakers of the cross, we may have a share also in his resurrection and in his life. And let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, sanctify these branches with your blessing, that we who follow Christ the King in exaltation may reach the eternal Jerusalem through him who lives and reigns forever and ever. Proclaim the good news with your joy, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus proceeded on his journey up to Jerusalem. As he drew near to Bethphage and Bethany, at a place called the Mount of Olives, he sent two of his disciples. He said, "Go into the village opposite you, And as you enter it, you will find a colt tethered on which no one has ever sat. Untie it. Bring it here. And if anyone should ask you, why are you untying it? You will answer, the master has need of it. So those who had been sent went off and found everything just as he had told them. And as they were untying the colt, its owner said to them, why are you untying this colt? They answered, the master has need of it. So they brought it to Jesus, drew their cloaks over the colt, and helped Jesus to mount. As he rode along, the people were spreading their cloaks on the road. And now, as he was approaching the slope of the Mount of Olives, the whole multitude of his disciples began to praise God aloud with joy for all the mighty deeds they have seen. They proclaimed, blessed is the King who comes in the name of the Lord. Peace in heaven and glory in the highest. Some of the Pharisees in the crowd said to him, teacher, rebuke your disciples. He said in reply, I tell you, if they keep silent, the stones will cry out. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who as an example of humility for the human race to follow, caused Jesus the Christ to take flesh and submit to the cross, graciously grant that we may heed his lesson of patient suffering and so merit a share in his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord God has given me a well-trained tongue, that I might know how to speak to the weary, a word that will rouse them. Morning after morning, he opens my ear that I may hear, and I have not rebelled, have not turned back. I give my back to those who beat me, my cheeks to those who plucked my beard. My face I did not shield from the buffets and spitting. The Lord God is my help. Therefore, I am not disgraced. I have set my face like flint, knowing that I shall not be put to shame. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Christ Jesus, though he was in the form of God,
did not regard equality with God something that needs to be grasped. Rather, he emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, coming in human likeness and found in human appearance. He humbled himself, becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Because of this, God greatly exalted him and bestowed on him the name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bend, of those in heaven and on earth and those below, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory to God the Father. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please be seated.
As Jesus approached Jerusalem, the people were waving palm branches and spreading their cloaks on the road. The whole multitude of his disciples began to praise God aloud with joy for all the mighty deeds they had seen. They proclaimed, "Blessed be the King who comes in the name of the Lord. Peace in heaven and glory in the highest." Jesus, the Messiah, the long-awaited King of the Jews, had come again to Jerusalem. What a week for Jesus it was to be.
This common crowd is much too loud. Tell the mob who sing your song that they are fools and they are wrong. They are a curse. They should disperse.
Oh, waste your breath moaning at the crowd. Nothing can be done to stop the shouting. If every tongue was still, the noise would still continue. The rocks and stones themselves would start to sing.
Hosanna, 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 Hosanna. AJC, won't you fight for me? Hosanna, Hosanna, hey, superstar.
Sing me your songs, but not for me alone. Sing them for yourselves, for you are blessed. There is not one of you who cannot win the kingdom. The slow, the suffering, the quick, the dead.
The chief priest and elder brought Jesus before Pilate. Pilate was the judge of the whole land in Jerusalem. Many people came and told lies about Jesus, but Jesus didn't answer them. Jesus knew he was innocent. Pilate asked Jesus, "Don't you hear what they are saying about you?" Jesus remained silent, and Pilate continued, "Are you the king of the Jews?" Jesus looked at Pilate and said, "That is your term." Pilate knew that Jesus wasn't guilty. Pilate figured that the priests and elders were just jealous of Jesus, wanted to teach him a lesson. They probably wanted him to leave the city. So he remembered that it was a festival week. They had an old custom that allowed the judge to free one prisoner if the people approved it. And Pilate thought, "I'll grab the worst, the meanest prisoner in jail, the insurrectionists. I'll offer the people Jesus or this murderer, this criminal. Surely they'll take Jesus." Pilate grabbed Barabbas and said, "Because it's festival week, I am releasing one prisoner to you. Today, you have a choice. Jesus or Barabbas." Pilate just knew they would let Jesus go free, and he said, "Which one do you want me to set free?"
"Barabbas, Barabbas, give us Barabbas."
Pilate was surprised, and he asked the crowd, "Then what am I to do with Jesus, your so-called king of the Jews?"
"Crucify him, nail him to the cross, crucify him."
Pilate knew that crucifixion would mean death to Jesus, and he hadn't done anything wrong for such an awful way to die. Pilate shouted back, "Why, what crime did he commit?"
"Crucify him, crucify him, crucify him."
Pilate couldn't get a straight answer out of the crowd. He was afraid that they would break out into a riot, so he called for a bowl of water. He dipped his hands into the bowl and said, "Okay, but I wash my hands of this whole matter. It is you. You people out there, you are sending this Jesus to the cross, not me. Crucify him."
"Crucify him, crucify him."
Pilate released Barabbas to the crowd. He had his soldiers take Jesus to their jail till they had time to get his cross ready. The soldiers ripped the clothes off Jesus. They treated him with contempt and laughed at him, took turns hitting him. One soldier got the bright idea to dress Jesus up to look like a king of the Jews. They placed a magnificent robe about his shoulders and they laughed at him. One soldier found a stick nearby, placed it in his hand as a king's ruling scepter. Jesus just hung his head down in great sadness and sorrow. Then another soldier looked around for a king's crown. He saw some sticker bushes nearby, and he pulled a few strands out. He rolled them up into a crown, stuck it on Jesus' head. He pushed it down hard until the thorns went into his skin and he began to bleed, and they all laughed at him and ridiculed him. They even bowed down on their knees, laughing at this funny-looking king, as they said, "All hail the king of the Jews. All hail this king, the king of the Jews." When they were tired of making a fool of Jesus, they got up. One soldier took the robe off Jesus. Another quickly grabbed a stick out of his hand and he beat him again. They all laughed. The soldiers put Jesus' clothes back on him, took him out of the jail. They gave him his cross to carry all the way to the top of the hill called Golgotha. Jesus was so beaten, he could not believe he would be able to carry that cross. "To the top, King of the Jews," one soldier shouted as they all pointed to Golgotha. They kicked him as he started the long climb. Soldiers to say no. Besides, he felt sorry for Jesus. He looked into Jesus' eyes and carried his cross to the top of the hill. When they reached the top of Golgotha, the soldiers laid Jesus upon the cross. Jesus couldn't believe his eyes when they saw a soldier get out long nails and a hammer. He was too tired to pull away. The soldier hammered a nail into Jesus' right hand. Then he nailed his other hand into the splintered wood of the cross. Another soldier nailed a sign to the top of the cross and laughed. They lifted the cross and dropped it into a small hole so it would stand firm. The soldiers sat around waiting for Jesus to die. They even rolled dice for his clothes. They left him with nothing, not even his last piece of clothing. Jesus cried out, "Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani." That means, my God, why have you forsaken me?" This call to God scared the elder, who quickly grabbed a sponge. He dipped it in a bucket of old cheap wine, raised it up on a stick to offer Jesus a drink. But the chief priest stopped him and said, "Wait, he's calling on God to help him. Let's see if God will do it." And once again, Jesus cried out, began to give up his spirit.
Oh, God.
There was a terrible windstorm when Jesus died, and the earth trembled. One soldier even said, "Clearly, this was the Son of God." Then some friends took Jesus off the cross to carry him off to their tomb to be buried. Today's the day, the people of Jerusalem shouted. Jesus, the great prophet, the Messiah, the long-awaited King of the Jews, was coming to the city. He would spend only 1 week there. Only 1 week. And what a week it was for Jesus.
thank the eighth graders for their reverent portrayal of the Passion. It's a very powerful expression of mime of our Lord's Passion. And when they come back in and towards the end, we'll give them a nice round of applause. I also want to thank Sandy Bailey, their teacher, and Mary Jo Orsini, the DRE, and all of the mothers and the people who are taking care of the lights. I really appreciate that. So let's stand and say the creed, please. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Knowing that in his passion, Jesus still lifted up all things to his God, the Father, we have the courage to pray together.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. For all members of the church, as we begin the journey of Holy Week, may the teaching of the gospel be an instrument of God's message of peace and eternal presence. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
This is a time of prayer and reflection. May we turn to Christ during this Holy Week and find God's love in all the people of our daily lives. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
During this Holy Week, let us pray for leaders of all nations, that they strive for peace. And we especially remember the innocent people of Ukraine whose lives have been scarred by war and violence. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who suffer in body, mind, or spirit, may they be given the strength to carry their crosses, knowing the Lord recognizes their weight and is always ready to share their burden. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who gather at this table of worship, may we imitate our Lord, accepting our share in his cross and serving others with humility and Christ consciousness. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We especially remember Lee Seiple. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. Thank you, God, for loving us and working with us and through us. We make our prayer in the name of our Lord Jesus.
Joy to honor you. Amen. joy to honor you.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Through the passion of our Lord Jesus the Christ, may our reconciliation with you be near at hand, so that we do not merit it by our own deeds, yet by this sacrifice made once for all, we may feel already the effects of your love and mercy. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, holy God, almighty and eternal, through Jesus the Christ. For though innocent, he suffered willingly for sinners and accepted unjust condemnation to save the guilty. His death was washed away our sins. His resurrection has purchased our justification. So with all the angels, we praise you as with joyful celebration we acclaim. Therefore, Almighty God, we bless through Jesus the Christ, who comes in your name. He himself is the word that brings salvation, the hand you extend to us sinners, and the way by which your peace and love is offered to us. When we ourselves have turned away from you on account of our misdeeds, you brought us back to the reconciliation, O Lord, so that converted at last to you, we might love one another through Jesus whom for our sake you handed over to death. Now, celebrating the reconciliation Christ has brought to all of us, we entreat you to sanctify these gifts by the outpouring of the Spirit, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, whose command we fulfill when we celebrate these mysteries. For what about to give his life to set us free? He reclined at supper. He himself took bread, took it into his hands in giving thanks. He said the blessing, and broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more, giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Celebrating, therefore, the memorial of the death and resurrection of Jesus the Christ, who left us a pledge of his love, we offer you what you have bestowed on us, the sacrifice of perfect reconciliation. Holy God, we humbly beseech you to accept us also together with Jesus, and in his saving banquet graciously to endow us with his very Spirit, who takes away everything that estranges us from one another. May he make your church a sign of unity, an instrument of your peace among all people, and may he keep us in communion with our Pope Francis and David our Bishop and all bishops, and people, all people throughout the world. Just as you have gathered us now at the table of Jesus, we also bring us together with the glorious Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and saints, with all our brothers and sisters, and those of every tongue and race who have died in your friendship, remembering especially Lee Seiple. Bring us the share, bring Lee and the share with them to be unending the banquet of unity and love in the new heaven and a new earth where the fullness of your peace will shine forth in Jesus the Christ. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teachings, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Gloria. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. And let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Peace, 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 Robert, peace. This is our Lord Jesus, who loves us all unconditionally, invites us all to share this Eucharistic mystery of life and love. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. I like the young men and women who portrayed so reverently the Passion. To please stand. They're all in the back over there. You did a marvelous job. I must have seen this maybe 50 or so times, and just your reverent portrayal of the Passion really, I mean, gets me in the heart. Thank you for your thank you for all the times you practiced and etc. And thank you for portraying the Passion. Let's give them a nice round of applause, huh? And once again, we want to thank their teacher, Miss Sandy Bailey. Let's give her a nice round of applause. There. And, I think our DRE went over to CCD, Mary Jo Orsini. We'll give her a round of applause in absentia, huh? I want to thank the stage crew and all the parents and grandparents of the children who performed this. Thank you. Let's give them a nice round of applause. Huh? And the stage crew is very important. Let us pray. Nourished with these sacred gifts, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, that just as through the death of Jesus the Christ, you have brought us hope for what we believe, so by his resurrection, you may lead us to where you call through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us all, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom.